Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Trouble Free. In today's video, we are going to learn about the digital audio broadcasting, which is in short called as DAB, in the subject of mobile computing. So first, let's see what digital audio broadcasting is. It is a digital radio standard for broadcasting digital audio services in many countries, for broadcasting the digital audio services. Right, it is a standard, it is a radio standards. You have some radio standards, right? You have digital audio broadcasting and digital video broadcasting in that. In this video, we'll learn about digital audio broadcasting. In the next coming video, we'll learn about digital video broadcasting. Done. So, it is a digital radio standard, and that is for used for broadcasting the audio services. And we can listen to digital audio broadcasting through a PC or through a RC, through a personal computer or through a radio cart. RC is radio cart. Okay. So through a personal computer or through a radio cart, we can listen to the digital audio broadcasting. Okay. Next, digital audio broadcasting in Europe. In Europe countries, work with the protocol Eureka 147 protocol is used in Europe. In Asia, IBAC and IBOC protocols are used for digital audio broadcasting. Okay, next. What is the frequency band? VHF band 3 and UHFL band are the frequency bands on which digital audio broadcasting will work. Right? So, these two are the bands on which it will work. Next. It has multiple carriers. Right? In digital audio broadcasting, you will have multiple carriers. And each carrier will have orthogonal nodes. Okay, orthogonal nodes are present in each and every carrier, right? Actually, I have to include about the features here, but still I forgot about the features. I'll be explaining about the features in the end of the video. As of now, let me tell what is this orthogonal nodes and all, what is the principle, main principle used in this. And it works on OFDM, orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. The word itself says what all is done in this particular OFDM, right? Orthogonal, it has orthogonal nodes, it does frequency division, and it also does multiplexing, right? And how frequency division is done? Frequency division is done by using FHSS, frequency hopping spread spectrum. By using FHSS, frequency division is done. Okay, and how, why, what is the need of frequency division? I'll tell you. See, you'll not have a single carrier, right? You'll have multiple subcarriers. You'll have so many subcarriers, right? So frequency has to be distributed equally to each and every subcarrier, right? So that is done by this FHSS. What FHSS will do is, it is a technique which will spread the data over large number of subcarriers which are spaced at equal frequency intervals. Okay, it will spread the data, it will share the data to all the subcarriers which are placed at equal frequency intervals. Okay, that is the function of FHSS. And it also does multiplexing, right? So multiplexing is again done in three steps. I'll tell you what those are. You will have a data in the form of frames. In digital audio broadcasting, data will be in the form of frames. And what is the format of that frames? I'll tell you now. It has three multiplexing channels. Okay, number one is main service channel, which is also called as MSC, synchronized channel, which is also called as SyncC, and fast information channel, FIC. Okay, so what does each service channel will do? I'll tell you. Main service channel multiplexer, what it will do is, it will take the input. What is the input that it takes? It will take the audio encoded data from the radio service and also data from the data services. Data services are nothing but images or any, apart from audio, if you are having anything, that will also taken as the input. Audio will be taken from the radio services and the remaining data will be taken from the data services. These both will be acting as an input for this main service channel multiplexer. Okay, this main service channel multiplexer will be taking input. Audio and data will be taken as input and it will process the data, right? Then we have the synchronization channel. It is used for synchronization of frames. The name itself says that, right? And then we have the fast information channel. What does this fast information channel does? This fast information channel will have all the control related information it will have, right? And the information will be in the form of a 240 bits message plus 16 bits checksum will be there. 240 bits normal message plus 16 bit checksum in addition to this 240 bits, right? So the data frames format, we have three multiplexing channels in this. We have discussed in OFDM also, right? OFDM means orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. So the multiplexing concept you can see here. We have three multiplexing channels: main service channel, synchronization channel, fast information channel, and each has got its own individual tasks, right? Now, so this is about how digital audio broadcasting is done. The next is we have the features of DAB. Okay, before that, I'll again revise how digital audio broadcasting is done. It is mainly done by the help of OFDM, orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. Orthogonal means it has orthogonal nodes. Each carrier will have orthogonal nodes, and frequency division means the data will be, to all the subcarriers which are placed at equal intervals, data will be divided equally. Data division will be done equally to each and every subcarrier. That is frequency division. And the last one is multiplexing. This is all about multiplexing, right? So now let's move into the features of the digital audio broadcasting. Number one is suitable for new or dynamic services. See, we can simply explain that as you can set your own voice, you can set your own music power ratio, you can adjust your own ratios, and you can have a dynamic range. Apart from always going with what is given by the computer, you can do your own things also. According to your choice also you can do, right? That means you can include new services also, right? And along with audio you can also transmit songs, traffic information, radio text, all song text, all that you can transmit apart from audios also, right? And low transmit power than analog FM. When compared to analog FM, it has a low transmit power. Done. And 15 to 20 programs per carrier. As I said, we have so many subcarriers and carriers in this, right? So in each carrier you can transmit from 15 to 20 programs. And what is the transmit speed? It can transmit 2.304 megabits per second, right? It can transmit 2.304 megabits of data per 1 second, and it uses a concept of codec, CODEC. CO means coding, DEC means decoding, right? What does this mean? In coding, what we do is we will compress the data for reducing the number of bits. Suppose if the audio is of let us take 21 bits, then we compress it to some 15 or 14 bits, right? By removing some, by removing some unwanted data or by removing some symbols or anything, we will be compressing it. And what happens in decoding is when the data reaches the receiver, then the receiver will be getting back the full audio by decompression. So here the compression is done, right? Here the reverse of compression, like how we do encryption and decryption in cyber security, the same happens here. The data is first compressed using coding, and the compressed data is decompressed on reaching the receiver side, and he can retrieve the full audio, right? So this is about the digital audio broadcasting, and I hope the video is you guys understood what I explained. If not, if it was confusing, I'm sorry for that. I tried my best, but still I hope you guys to understand this. And thanks for watching the video. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and also share it with your friends so that it will be useful for your friends as well. And also, if you're still having any doubts, let me know in the comment section. If you understood, then hit the like button and also share it with your friends. And any doubts, I would like to, I mean, I'll try to clarify. You can ask me in the comment section or through the contact details that I mentioned in the description box. And thank you for watching the video. Let's meet up soon in the next video with another new topic. Stay tuned to my channel. Till then, subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can receive the notifications whenever I post a video.